Hello, we are here for one more lesson of this 4MCAD training course, and the topic for today will be hiding, shading, rendering. This is a subtopic of the program. In fact, if you want to go deep in this matter, it is very complex and has a lot of concepts that you need to be very professional, and you need to know them very well. I will show you a very basic approach to this topic. I will start to create one solid just to be our solid, and so that we can see the final result out of this. And to start telling that we have several visualization modes. One of them, one very basic one, is the shaded mode, which it is a quick visualization of your elements. This mode does not have any light source, and you can see the elements in flat colors. So it's very basic. So view, shade, and you basically see something like this. Okay, very easy, and it's a direct function. Then you go to more complex stuff, and the more complex stuff it is the render that you have one menu dedicated only to the render. We can have a smaller or a simpler visualization mode also, which we call the height, that is something like this, okay? Besides the shade. So in terms of the two basic ways to visualize your drawing, you have these two. When you go into more complex stuff, then you come to the render. Render has a lot of options, and starting above, you have a material library where you can assign materials to your elements. So you can say aluminum, then you can say import, and you have this available in your materials list. Okay, so now if I want to go and say this cube is of aluminum, I can attach or I can assign the aluminum to the material. Then you can also edit your material. So I have my material list, I can say modify. I have a lot of parameters, okay, a lot of these things. I will not go one by one because it will become very deep. You can modify the colors, even the file that is the base for the assignment of this material. Okay, you have a lot of things that you can work around. Then you can also, in terms of the light sources, you can say, oh, I want to have a sunlight in here or not. And having the sunlight, you can choose one city because it depends on the place you are for the position of the sun in the sky. So, and even say the date because it will be different. Okay? This is quite important to have a more realistic light. You can create your own light sources, so you can give it a name and pick a point, okay, and the height of the light. You can have all of these things. You can also edit your lights, and I can edit my sunlight or others that I might create it in terms of colors, intensities, and locations. You can also have a background. The background is an image, so you can have a solid background, or you can choose one image with a photo or with something like that, because it will help a lot your final result in terms of a realistic look. You can activate or enable fog, and then you can for sure define all the things related with the fog also. You can have objects that we call landscape objects. They help a lot in terms of a realistic look also. So you have these objects, you can position them, and you can even edit these objects. I don't have any object created because I did not insert an object, but I can do it. So, okay, I can put one object here. And then I can go and select the object and change it, modify it. In terms of the objects, okay, I have the object, I can modify them, okay, in terms of the images and where are they in your PC. And finally, I have the definition of the render options, so I can choose among different algorithms for the render, being the OpenGL the simpler one, and this is the more complex, where you can have a lot of shades, lights, a lot of things here, okay? Reflections. So you can have all these configurations, you can make this to the window or to file, so you can configure a lot of things. Finally, when all it is set, you just say render, and then it will apply a render to the definitions you have and to the objects you place, whatever. I haven't done any particular definitions, even because if we create a very good definition for the render, it will take some time to do the calculation. Just one final point to this, it's not possible when you have a final render done, it's not possible to make a print out of the file directly. So you can do the print, but you have to do it to a file. So in terms of the render options, you need to destination, you create a file and then you print out of this file. It can be a BMP, a TGA, a PNG, whatever, okay? But you must print out of this file, not directly from the drawing area as you do with other things. So, very simple and fast way, these are the possibilities to work with the render options, with the visualization topics for MCAD.